Yes, hello everyone, and welcome to this session on introducing the power of ArcGIS. Our aim today is that you come away with an understanding of what ArcGIS is, where it can be used, and what it can be used for. So you've got two of us today. My name is Carmel Connolly. I'm a lead consultant with Esri UK.
And I'm Laurie Stevens. I'm a GIS consultant, and Carmel and I work in similar roles, helping users to understand how they can use ArcGIS in their organisation.
Yes. So before we begin, I wanted to ask, have you ever wanted to modify how your attribute information is displayed as labels, but you don't want to or maybe can't change how the underlying data is formatted? Or have you ever wanted to explore relationship between data on the fly, but you don't want to do that analysis? Well, these kind of scenarios are where ArcGIS can come in really useful. And Laurie's going to go into a little bit more detail about these scenarios later on. So let's begin with, well, what is ArcGIS? ArcGIS is a lightweight scripting language that's available across the ArcGIS system, from desktop to online to mobile. It was developed by Esri and released in 2017 to meet the needs of the ArcGIS system that other languages couldn't. It works client-side, so it performs really well and doesn't need any extra infrastructure behind it to work. Now, this is not a language that you build applications with. It's a language that allows you to do enhanced data configuration, so you can really shape it for your needs. It's currently on version 1.17, and it has the same release cycle as ArcGIS Online, so keep an eye out for even more functionality to come. Who can use ArcGIS? Well, anyone can use ArcGIS. There are no extra installs required. It comes pre-packaged with the ArcGIS software, so it's likely you already have access to it. If, like me, you don't come from a developer background, ArcGIS is accessible because it's lightweight and relatively new. There is a rich library of functions that you can use to build your scripts from, so you're not starting from scratch. I'd recommend by starting small, finding some functions that are of interest to you, apply them to your data, and then work from there. If you are familiar with other scripting languages like JavaScript or Python, ArcGIS should be familiar because it has similar logic like if statements or for loops. You should be able to get off to a flying start with it, and hopefully it will complement your work. What can I use ArcGIS for? Well, ArcGIS has something called profiles, and a profile is the context in which an ArcGIS expression is used. This is a sample of 19 plus profiles that are available for you. Some of them are self-explanatory, like labeling, so this is the context in which you can use ArcGIS to label your data. For example, here I have some local authority boundaries where I'm using a field for labeling. You can see at the end it's included a string LPA. I can use the function left to strip this string off of it, so we're left with just the name of that local authority. Now, that left function might feel a little bit familiar to you, and it could be the case that you've used it in Excel, and they work in the exact same way. And it's that kind of familiarity between something like Excel and ArcGIS is actually how I built up my confidence and skill in using the language. For other profiles, the help documentation is really clear to understand where and what they can be used for. Where can I create ArcGIS? Well, you can create ArcGIS in lots of different places, through desktop and in ArcGIS Pro, through a browser and in the map viewer available with online and enterprise, through ArcGIS applications like dashboards, field maps, and suite, and also in our ArcGIS developer tools like the runtime and JavaScript API. Where can I consume ArcGIS? So that ArcGIS that you've just created in these products can also be consumed in them as well. And in addition, also in other ArcGIS applications like story maps or instant apps. ArcGIS being portable and accessible in all of these locations essentially means you can create your ArcGIS script once and it's available everywhere. What can I use ArcGIS on? ArcGIS can be used on a variety of data sources, whether that's feature, map, or image services, and even tables. You can also work with relationships, whether that's relationships between spatial data or making use of relationships established through a data schema. You can also use ArcGIS on any data that you have access to. So whether you own it, another organization owns it, it's coming from an open data site, or even from the Living Atlas. Now I'm going to hand you over to Laurie to see this in action.
Thanks, Carmel. So over the next 10 minutes or so, I'm just going to walk through a series of demonstrations that show just some of the ways in which ArcGIS can be used across the ArcGIS system. And to really try and emphasize the power and accessibility of ArcGIS, all of the expressions we're going to see over the next 10 minutes require no more than 3 lines of code. On the screen now, you can currently see a map in ArcGIS Pro, and it's displaying UK historical earthquakes, a data set available through the ArcGIS Living Atlas, thanks to the British Geological Survey. If we select an earthquake feature from the map, you'll see that in our pop-up, we get the locality of that earthquake. And currently, that's all displayed in capital letters. In my pop-up, I'd like that data to use the correct casing. And we can do this through the use of an ArcGIS function. To create this in ArcGIS Pro, we right-click on our layer in the Contents pane, select Configure Pop-ups, come to Expressions, and then select New. And this is going to open up our ArcGIS Expression Builder. We're going to start by giving our expression a name and a title. And then we're going to use our fields and ArcGIS functions to build our expression. To apply the correct casing to this field, I'm going to use an ArcGIS function called proper. And I just double-click it to insert it into my expression. I then need to insert my parameters, which in this case is just the field I want to apply the formatting to, which is locality. I can check that my expression is valid, select OK, and then select where I'd like that expression to appear in my pop-up. And you'll now see that when I select the earthquake point from the map, we have our correctly formatted location thanks to our ArcGIS expression. ArcGIS is fantastic for data formatting, be that text, numeric, or date data, and is particularly useful in a use case like this, where we don't actually have access or ability to edit the underlying source data. Moving on to another example now, another way in which ArcGIS can be really useful is for understanding how different layers are related to each other. On my map, you can currently see 2 layers. In purple, we can see building footprints from OS OpenMap local important buildings. And in blue, we can see flood zone 3, which represents a 1-in-100-year probability of flooding. We can use ArcGIS to determine whether a building footprint is within 50 meters of flood zone 3. To do this, again, we're going to right-click on our layer, come to Configure Pop-ups, select Expressions, and I've already actually started this expression, so I'm going to select Edit. We're going to start by creating a couple of variables that we need to create this expression. The first thing we want to do is create our flood zone variable, and we're going to do this by connecting to our flood zone layer in our map. And we do this using a function called featureSetByName. Having done that, again, we just need to provide the parameters for that function, which is where's that data coming from, which is my map, what's the name of the layer, which is flood zone 3, and that's it. Next, we need to buffer our building features, and we're going to do this using the ArcGIS buffer function. So again, I'm going to double-click to insert, and I need to provide my parameters again. I need to say what I want to buffer, which is the feature that I'm clicking on. I set my distance that I want to buffer by, which is 50, and then the units of measurement, which is meters. Finally, I now need to use these 2 variables that I've created to calculate whether that buffered building is within our flood zone. And I'm going to do this with a few ArcGIS expressions. So if the count of the intersection between our flood zone and our buildings buffered variable is greater than zero, then that means that yes, there is an intersection, and so we would like to display yes, that is within the flood zone. And if not, then we'd like to say no. We can again validate our expression, hit OK, and you'll now see that if we zoom into a building footprint, click it on the map, we'll see that within our pop-up, yes, that building is within 50 metres of flood zone 3. As Carmel mentioned, all arcade expressions are performed client-side. And so this is really nice that this kind of analysis is performed without you having to run an analysis tool and actually write a new output. Currently, we've seen how arcade can be used within pop-ups. But as Carmel mentioned, there are a number of other profiles which define where we can use arcade. And one of these is labeling. On my map, you can see ONS population estimates at the MSOA level across Manchester. To label these features, I come to the Labeling tab in ArcGIS Pro and hit this button to enable labeling. You'll see that when I do this, by default, it displays MSOAs according to their name. But I'd like to display both the MSOA name and MSOA code, which is available as another attribute in my layer. And so this is another great use case for arcade. We're going to open up our label expression builder. And again, we just need to use our fields and functions to create our expression. And arcade is really useful for concatenating both fields and strings. We're going to add our MSOA code. Hit validate again, hit apply, and you'll see that once we've done that, we can now see both our MSOA name and MSOA code displayed for our features. Having done that, we could then share this as a web map to either our ArcGIS Online or ArcGIS Enterprise organization. And in the interest of time, I've gone ahead and done this already. We're now in the map viewer within ArcGIS Online, and you'll see that we're actually viewing the same map that we were just looking at in ArcGIS Pro. And you'll immediately see that that arcade configuration that we've done in ArcGIS Pro has carried across to our web map. We can see our label expressions there. And if we come to our pop-up attribute expressions, you'll also see there's a number of arcade expressions within the pop-up that have also been carried through in the configuration. We've seen how arcade can be used with labeling and pop-ups, but we can also use arcade to create expressions that drive our map symbology. And I'm going to do this within the ArcGIS Online map viewer. I'm going to come to the styles pane, remove the existing attributes used to define symbology, and then click add expression. And this is again going to open up the expression builder within ArcGIS Online. This has a familiar layout to ArcGIS Pro. We're able to give a name for our expression, build our expression, and then we have access to our field globals and our arcade functions here. I'm going to start by giving my expression a name. And for this expression, I'm going to calculate the percentage population change in the 5 to 11 age group. Now I'm ready to start building my expression. And I'm going to do this by creating a variable called population change. And I'm now going to use my field globals to calculate this population change. So I'm going to scroll down to where the 5 to 11 age fields are. And I'm going to calculate this. You'll see that clicking a field global automatically inserts it for me. And that's my population change there. And I'd like to return this value, but I'd only like to return it to one decimal place. And I can do this using the round arcade function, which I can search for. You'll notice that each arcade function has a little blue eye next to it. If you select this, you'll see it takes you to a page. And I'd really recommend you have a look at this, as it contains some really useful information on how you can use the function and the parameters you need to provide each function. Again, just clicking that function adds it to my expression, and you'll see it's actually added placeholders for me to tell me what parameters I need to provide, which in this case is my population change and the number of places I want to round to, which is one decimal place. I can hit test to see the sort of output I get, and if I'm happy with that, click OK, and then I just need to select the type of symbology I'd like my map to use, and I'm going to use counts and amounts. Having selected that, what you'll see is that my map symbology is being driven by that population change that I calculated with my arcade expression. We could then take this a step further if we wanted to by sharing this into a web application. For example, this application is created with the nearby instant apps template available within ArcGIS Online. We can see immediately that the arcade configuration for both our symbology and labeling has carried through, and that if we select a point on the map, it allows us to get demographic information about that location. And within our pop-up, we can also see those attribute expressions that I previously showed you being put to good use. And this just highlights the point that Arcade carries across the whole ArcGIS system, and you only need to configure it in one place. So that's all for this demonstration. I hope it's shown you just some of the ways in which Arcade can be used across the ArcGIS system, and I'd really, really encourage you to explore how you can use it within your workflows. And I'll now hand it back to Carmel.
Excellent. Thank you, Laurie. That's just incredible. In three lines of code or less, you know, Laurie's really demonstrated the power of Arcade. If that has inspired you, here are some resources to help you get started. Our developer documentation for Arcade is a great place to go to understand it a little more and get some answers to your questions. If you're interested in training, we have an Arcade path on our Learn ArcGIS platform with videos and tutorials on how to get started. We regularly release blogs on Arcade to give you tips and tricks and inspiration of where it can be used. We have the Esri community, a forum where you can go to view and ask questions about Arcade and other ArcGIS functionality. Here you have access to our Esri colleagues and also other people from organizations like yourselves. Esri also have a GitHub repository of Arcade scripts that are available for each of those profiles that I mentioned earlier. It's a really nice place to go to see Arcade used in those different contexts. Now, the focus of this session was to give you an introduction to Arcade, but we wanted to leave you with a little taste of the art of the possible. What else could you use it for? Arcade can be used in dashboards for formatting to maybe highlight certain thresholds, certain metrics that have gone above or below certain thresholds. In this example, I've highlighted are the row closures that have gone beyond their proposed finish date are highlighted. Arcade can be used in ArcGIS Pro for attribute calculations. In this particular instance, the user is choosing the species in English, but you'll notice that the species in Latin is being automatically populated or updated based upon that previous choice. And Arcade can be used in field maps in form calculations. In this instance, the user is adding a point to the map. The attribute, reserve name, is automatically being populated based upon the polygon that it is intersecting with. By incorporating Arcade in these kind of workflows can make them more efficient and also remove issues like user issues like things like spelling mistakes. Thank you very much for joining us today. If you have any questions, we'll both be at the Ask a Developer stand for the next half an hour. And yeah, thank you very much for joining us. Thank you.